This demon is making its way around the town. It's corrupting everything, ruining this place. I might have to pull out the cookies very soon. Very, very soon, but not today. Welcome back, Elites. How you doing? It's me, your boy, Villager Master 68 here. Today's episode, we are back over at the jungle base. I'm loving this place, and today we're going to build something new, something cool, and I think I've scoped out the spot. We're going to build it right over there. But first, let's intro the project a little bit. So, over here we have Axolotl. Axolotl is doing amazingly. Keep it up, Axolotl. Doing great. Wish you would sleep less, but doing great. Yeah, so Axolotl, the mending villager, is doing great. But, unfortunately, Axolotl is the only villager that we have. You see, if we can harness the power of villagers, then we can basically create an infinite source of iron. All we have to do is play the game, which is pretty easy, and then the iron will just stack up. It will be raked in, which is something that I absolutely love the sounds of. So the end goal, an iron farm. Today, the first move towards it, a villager breeder. To build an iron farm, we're gonna need three villagers. Now, sure, of course, I could just, really, take 3 villagers from a village and build the iron farm, but if I want to trade with other villagers, which I definitely will want to, I'd like to make lots of emeralds in this world, then I'm gonna need even more villagers. How do we get more villagers easily? Villager breeder. So villager breeders are actually really, really simple to build. There are 2 major, well, maybe 3 major components behind a villager breeder. Component number 1, 2 villagers. Component number 2, a couple of beds. Component number 3, food. That's literally it. It is so, so easy. The villager breeder that we're going to build today will work in Java Edition 1.16 and up. Not too sure about Bedrock, but I'm pretty sure. So first things first, we need a spot for our villager breeder, a location. I think I've already picked it out. It's gonna be right in here. We need to clear things out, but this should be a really, really solid spot for our villager breeder. The biggest thing that we need to keep in mind when picking a location for our villager breeder is the other things that are going to be around. So a villager breeder pretty much contains itself. It's not that big. We're gonna need like probably a 10 by 10 block area. It's pretty small. But a villager breeder can definitely affect the things around it because of the villagers inside of it. If we're going to build an iron farm in this world, which we definitely will, this villager breeder is basically going to be considered a village. Our iron farm should be its own separate village. So, what I'm saying here is if you're going to build an iron farm, definitely don't put your villager breeder anywhere near your iron farm. You don't want anything to get messed up, like, at all. Your villager breeder can be near other villagers, like Axolotl is like right over there, but the iron farm needs to be far, far away. So that's why I'm picking this isolated corner. Now, before we can actually build the villager breeder, I need to clear some of this stuff out because it is literally everywhere. I have a really cool build theme that I want to do with the villager breeder. It's actually going to be a little bit different than what we've been doing over there, but the plants, they're still in the way. No matter what I'm going to do, definitely 100% in the way. Now, initially, I was thinking about maybe setting this thing back in between these 2, I guess, hills here, but I think I'd like to actually pull it out a little bit more, because what I'm gonna do is set this villager breeder up, and then we'll set up a dock near it. To move our villagers around in this world, because we have so much water, I figured boats would be literally the perfect move. I mean, look at this. There's a giant water right here. We could just set up a dock, move our villagers over to the boats, put them in the boat, I get in the boat too, and then I sail them to wherever I need them to go. Minecart lines would definitely work for moving villagers around too, but of course, they require a whole lot more effort, and honestly, they're just not as efficient. Alright, boom, there we go. Hopefully this will be enough room. If it's not, not that big of a deal. We could always push the land out on the left, or take this down a little bit on the right. So, villager breeder. First things first, the materials. What do you need to get to build a villager breeder? Well, right here are the materials that we'll be needing, basically, in kind of almost exact amounts. So, we're gonna need 4 beds, a composter, 3 trapdoors, any type of trapdoor will work, and then some crops. Now, the crops are the first spot that I'd like to stop. For villagers to breed, they're either going to need 3 pieces of bed in their inventory, or 12 carrots, or 12 potatoes, or 12 beetroot. Carrots, in my opinion, are the best bet, because a villager's inventory won't get as filled up. I mean, think about it. When you plant a carrot, and then you harvest a carrot, what do you get? You literally get a carrot. With wheat, when you harvest it, you get wheat and seeds. Then you have to turn the wheat into bread, so there's another step involved. With potatoes, you get potatoes and poisonous potatoes, which are pointless for all of this. With beetroot, you get beets and you get beetroot seeds. Again, 2 things, not worth it. Carrots, you only get carrots. If you don't have carrots, don't worry about it, use any of the other crops, but carrots are our go-to. You're also gonna wanna have some land that you can plant on, so for us, some dirt, which we definitely have. Then the optionals. maybe a sticky piston if you want to turn this thing on and off. Depending on how you're going to move your villagers, you might want to have some signs. Depending on how you want to do your water source, you could have a water loggable block or not. And then, if you'd like, to help move your villager into this thing, you could have a second workstation. Villagers are highly motivated by jobs. Alright, so first things first, we need to pick the center. The center is going to be the waterlogged block, the water that will fuel this whole farm, basically. Keep it hydrated. So, maybe we put our center, I don't know, maybe we tuck it, like, right here. Then, from the center block, we're gonna go four blocks out in every direction. So, four that way, then we're gonna go four over this way, four this way, boom, just like that, and then finally, four out this way. Then after that, we're gonna fill everything in. So it looks like this villager breeder, this base is going to just barely fit in here, which is perfect. It's just barely perfect, but perfect. We'll probably end up pushing the land back anyways though, because of course I want to make the farm look pretty good. So far, this is a pretty simple, solid start. After placing all of our dirt down, we're gonna go ahead and waterlog that slab right there. After that, we're gonna go ahead and grab our composter. The composter will go right in the center of this farm. We can put the composter right above that, just like that, and then we're good to go. Now, right above the composter, we're going to need to place a block. Any block will do. Villagers can still use composters if there's a block above them, but what they can't do is jump on top of the composter. 100% don't want the villager jumping on the composter. If it jumps on the composter, then it's actually gonna jump off of the composter and turn this land over here that will be farmland into dirt, which is definitely a huge problem. Now, after this, what we wanna do is get some walls on this thing. Now our walls are gonna be different. I'm gonna try something out that I've never done before. Here's what I'm thinking. A variation, a mixture of dark oak wood and spruce wood, just sort of piled up here. I wanna make this look really natural, like almost like a tree, or it was a giant tree, and now it's just the base of a tree. I think these wood tones could blend together really, really well in here, if, of course, I can pull it off. Now the point to this thing, the goal here is gonna be like randomization. Some of it gets taller, some of it gets shorter. Also, we want to sort of break out of the square shape, I think. So some of this will spill down, and I will definitely end up terraforming the land out a little bit in here. But yeah, some of it spills down and stays short, and then other bits of it stay, like, taller. So, I don't know. We're gonna need the walls to at least be two blocks tall in there, for sure. This is gonna be tricky, but I'm thinking something kind of like that with more randomization. To help it get even more randomized, I think I should probably come back in here with spruce slabs. Or actually, maybe dark oak slabs. Those might fit a little bit better. The big thing here, though, is that the walls on the inside are at least two blocks tall. Now, you don't need to use wood when doing this. You could use glass, you could use cobblestone, you could use literally anything that villagers can't get out of. If you don't put secure walls on this thing, though, you could have huge problems. Your villagers could get out of it, which is definitely not what you want, or zombies and other bad things could get inside of it, which is also, probably not what you want. I already know that I'm not gonna have enough wood, so here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna plant a spruce tree over here. This will be our new spruce tree farming spot, and then we'll put dark oak over here, and when they grow, I'll go ahead and, of course, chop them down. Now, I think that I could actually, maybe, use this hill to my advantage. I could probably have this thing sort of blend into the hill, and then with this thing blended into the hill, that's a whole lot of wood that I get to skip out on, which is something that I absolutely love the sounds of. Now, my plan is to also come back in here and mix some leaves in here, and then also, probably, actually, some windows. I think if I put, like, a couple of random windows in here, that would be kind of cool. It really wouldn't do much for the villagers, of course, but if we did, like, brown stained glass in here, it would blend in and look like a window for the villagers, which is something that I also really, really love the sounds of. These villagers need to have the best life possible. Now, when you're setting up your walls, you're gonna wanna leave a hole in the middle of one side. For me, I'm gonna leave a hole in the middle of this side right here. This is gonna be the front of the farm. I'm gonna definitely have to terraform this out a little bit, but hole right here. Gamers, take a seat, because it's time. The day is finally here. This is a momentous moment in this series. It's a big day. A huge day, in fact. Big would be way understatement. Right here, the old trusty Iron Axe. It's been through many times, good times, bad times, many times. But today, everything probably just has to come to an end. Let's go ahead and check this out. Efficiency 4, that's beautiful. That's great. Quick charge 1, that's terrible. Efficiency 4, of course I'll take you. What else do we? We just get efficiency 4. That is absolute garbage. That's a really bad axe enchantment. You know what? I'm not going to take that. I am insulted by that, actually. Efficiency 4, this is the one. Oh, Fortune 3, efficiency 4, that's a little bit better. We'll keep it. We'll need Unbreaking 3. For sure, we'll need Unbreaking 3 on this. But, oh boy, that's a beautiful axe. I know there's some trees in the way. Well, actually, hold on. Let's try this again. Let's move over here. Okay. Mm-hmm. We'll move right over here. Okay. Yup. Mm-hmm. Check it out. I know there's a floating chest in the way, but this is what I have now. This is pretty much exactly what I was envisioning, minus the plants around it. So you check that grass area right out front. Gonna have to fill that in for sure. I actually might terraform that back now. I have a secret, though. You can't tell anybody. You have to promise. Top secret, important classified information. So the build, yep, it's coming along, looking pretty good. The walls are going to work, but the walls, let's talk about the walls a little bit. Hey, I don't know how to even get back there. It's so secret. Check this out. The wall back here on the backside. Mm-hmm. Way less inspiring, okay? Yeah, I know, and it's fine. It's cool. If I ever build anything back here, I'll go ahead and make sure I make it look better. But honestly, I don't know if I'll build anything over here, at least not anytime soon. So, anyways, this is what we have right now. Now, definitely want to come in here with some brown stained glass. So, let's go ahead and get this, and then all of the other glass too. So, the windows. I think the windows would be really, really cool on this build. This is the first brown dye in brown glass in the world. Look at that. Special. I want to put a window right over here. Boom, boom. Just like that. And then I want to put a window right over here like this. This window is going to be a little bit bigger. It's on the front. Then, finally, to use up this glass, this is what I want to do. I'm going to take that out, put glass here. Now, we have the walls of the way around this thing. The villagers would be stuck in here. I decided to move the entrance from this side over to that side. We'll talk about it in a minute. After getting the walls on this thing, you're going to want to put a ceiling on this thing. Now, my ceiling over here is going to be plain old. Well, you know what? Is my ceiling going to be plain colored glass or is it going to be brown colored glass? You know what? I think I'm going to stick to the initial plan here. I'm going to go ahead and do plain clear glass on the top of this thing all the way around. And then anywhere where I have a small gap, like right here, I'll probably just come in here to be safe and readjust it. So I'll move it up a little bit. I'll put a new slab back. Boom, there we go. I want this thing to be entirely 100% secure. What are the chances of something attacking the villagers through this little gap? Very, very unlikely, but maybe it could happen, maybe. So I'm not gonna let it happen. Now, just like with the walls, the ceiling can be built out of anything. It doesn't have to be glass. You could use cobblestone. You could use really whatever you'd like. I'm going with glass because I think glass would be cool. We'd be able to kind of see into the farm from the top, which would be nice. Eventually, we're going to have an elytra. Eventually, very, very soon. Yes, I know. But eventually, we'll have an elytra. And of course, with the elytra, we'll be in the sky. And in the sky, we'll be able to see the entrance of this thing, or the whole thing. You know what I mean. Now, after putting the ceiling on this thing, which I had the perfect amount of glass, by the way, but after putting the ceiling on this thing, we need to make sure it is nice and bright. If you use not glass, then it would be really dark in here. So we're gonna put lanterns in every single corner. If you don't have lanterns, don't worry about it. You could do torches on the wall too. Then, just to make sure everything is nice and safe, we'll put some torches in the middle too. Definitely, 100%, don't want anything bad happening in here. That's gonna keep things really, really safe. So for villagers to breed, again, we need 3 things. 2 villagers, we'll get those later. Food, which we'll be able to plant in here on the ground now because we have water under the composter, remember. And then finally, beds. Beds are a huge component of any villager breeder. For a villager breeder, we're gonna need 4 beds. I have 4 beds. Where do we wanna put these beds? Well, what we're gonna actually do is use the beds to lure the baby villagers out of this breeder. So the beds will actually be on the outside, kind of the villager breeder. We're gonna go ahead and clear a room over here. This room needs to be 3 blocks tall. There needs to be 2 clear blocks of space above the beds for this thing to work. If your beds don't have enough room, the villagers will never breed. So this right here is going to be the edge of the breeder. What we're gonna do is we're gonna dig down one, just like that. So we have 2 blocks dug out. Now, over here, we're gonna make a small platform out of probably, We'll go with spruce logs. Spruce logs will fit well in here. Always got to make everything look on point. You already know. So there we go. We have a small area with spruce, and then we're going to start laying our beds in here. So we'll put a bed there, a bed there, a bed there, and then finally, we'll put one more bed just like that. This is where the beds are going to be. The villagers will actually never sleep. They're going to be up 24/7. Now, we need to trick the villagers into thinking that they can get to the beds, because of course, down here, we're going to dig this down a little bit more to move our villagers out of this place. We'll actually dig it down 3 blocks just like that. Villagers would never try and cross this right out, which is a problem. How do we fix that? Well, check that. We put a trap door right there. We go over here, we put a trap door just like that. Then, if we open these trap doors, the villagers won't know that these trap doors are open, and they'll actually try and walk over this thing, which is perfect. Now, we're also going to go ahead and put a trap door right in here too. But I'm going to be picky, and I want it to go just like that. We're going to leave it right there. Perfect. This trap door is very, very, very important. We're going to leave this trap door closed, so just like that. The villagers will see this trap door as an open block, like the adult villagers, but obviously it's not an open block. So the adult villagers will think that they can get to the beds because everything is like this. They see all of this as walkable, movable spaces. It's not actually movable though for the adult villagers. And meanwhile, this trap door in this position just like this will of course let baby villagers right on through this thing. Baby villagers are tiny, so they'll be able to easily squeeze right under the space. Next up, we need to set up some sort of funneling system. So we'll jump down into this hole. Now, we're going to actually go ahead and dig this one more block down just like that, so we have a little bit of clearance, and then we're going to start digging it this way. Then, after going maybe like that far, I don't know, kind of just guessing here, we'll go ahead and turn it over this way. I want to move my villagers out to a dock, so I'm going to have to clear out whatever this is in here, probably another tree, and then set up a dock right here. That will be perfect. All we need to do is get the villagers around this bend. Moving the villagers out here is actually going to be pretty easy. So here's how we start. We have planks on the floor. That'll look pretty good. We'll come back in and change the walls out a little bit later. We'll put a water source right here, right down below this drop. The water source is going to flow down this way. Now, of course, we want to turn this corner, so we're going to need a little bit of ice here. We put a block of ice right there. We put a block of ice right there. Then we actually climb back up here, grab a sign, and put the sign right here on this block of ice. Then we're going to put a few more planks right in there and actually get a tiny bit more water. With the ice placed where it is and the sign right there and then another water source right there, the villagers will fall down into this stream and then move right around this corner. The ice is a little bit slippery. It'll help the villagers keep moving. If they do get stuck here, eventually they should wander into this and then continue to be moved down that way. Now for now, I put a sign right there. We're going to set this up in a minute. We're basically going to put a small room right there. This though, this all looks pretty good. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to heighten this in here and actually add just a little bit of lighting in here to be safe. Now, the ice around this bend might be a little bit expensive. If you don't have access to ice, don't worry about it. You could just do a straight shot. That would work perfectly fine. You could also maybe just do some kind of minecart system down here to pick up your villagers too, whatever you'd like. I'm going with the ice just because of my setup right here. I'd like to move the villagers a little bit closer to where I'm actually building. So, boom, here we go. We have lots of wood, a little bit of light in here. This will move the villagers right over to this spot right here. Then we'll set up a dock over here and move the villagers wherever we need to with this water right there. So, we are actually just about done with this farm. Temporarily, we're going to actually make a little hole right here so we can get in and out of this thing. This is how we'll move the villagers into this farm once we're ready for that. Now, this villager breeder will work. In fact, it'll probably work too good. We need to change that. This villager breeder would be running constantly, which is way, way more than I need. What we're going to do to stop that from happening is put a sticky piston right there and then a solid block right there. Whenever I power the sticky piston, the block will be pushed out just like that. This will cut off the villagers' path to these beds. Remember, this trap door is closed like that, but the villagers see right through it. This right here can't be seen through. The adult villagers will know now that there is no way over to these beds, and they won't breed, because for villagers to breed, they'll need beds. So, that's going to cut this thing on and off. If you can't afford a sticky piston, don't worry about it. It's technically optional. Just know that your villager breeder will be running constantly, which could create lag and will create a lot of villagers. Now, of course, I'm going to build a room around these beds. I need one other thing over here, though, too. I definitely want to have an indicator light, so this is what I'm thinking. We could probably put our indicator light like over here, and then I take down this tree. If this light is on, then the villager breeder will be on. If it's off, then the villager breeder will be off. How do we do that? Well, that should actually be pretty simple, actually. What we're going to want to do is start with probably a redstone torch right behind this lamp on a block. So we'll put the torch like right there. That'll probably be fine. Then we can go ahead and run a redstone wire behind all of these blocks over to the sticky piston. Here's how we'll do that one. We'll put a solid block right there. Then we'll run a wire just like this, going in between these two blocks. Now, whenever I put a lever in here, boom, that's off. This is pushed forward, which means the villager breeder is actually off. When that's on, everything is on, lights on, villager breeder is on. Alright, that all makes sense. Now all I need to do is figure out the design of this room. Need to remove that tree for sure, and then figure out where I want to put my lever. This lever really could go anywhere, but maybe I'll put it... This is the tricky part. So check this. If I were to put this lever, say, right there... Okay, that controls everything. Okay, that's good. Now, the big question. Can I reach the lever from, say, back here? Okay, I can. Okay. So this is what I'm thinking. Maybe right now, we could go ahead and do maybe glass around the edge here. And then in the center, we could put a trap door. This trap door will, of course, keep everything closed off in there. Then, if I need to, I could reach that and then turn the breeder on, turn the breeder off, just like that. Maybe, though, we move this lever down to, like, the dock area that I'm going to set up over here. Maybe, because that's where I'll actually be accessing the farm. So I'm not too sure, but for now, we'll put the lever on the wall. Ooh, maybe. Maybe something like that for now? I don't know. That's kind of cool looking. But anyways, let's go ahead and finish this farm up. So if we move inside of this thing, it's definitely time to till all of this land and plant our carrots. After that, we're going to need to go find two brand new villagers. So I'm thinking that the taiga village that's kind of near here probably is going to be our best bet for villagers. It should be a pretty easy shot. There's just a tiny bit of land that we need to cross, but that was really, really easy before with the first two villagers that we tragically brought over here. All right, boom, there we go. Everything's planted, which means it's definitely 100% time for the villagers. So, beautiful jungle base, I will be back soon. Let's go ahead and grab this, grab the boat, and let's go on our way. The closest village is going to be right down the water over this way. Oi, villagers, how you all doing? What's going on? You have never been traded with before. You coming with me, get in the boat, let's go. Now, when you're moving your villagers over to your villager breeder, you definitely need at least one villager that can take a job and has not been traded with before. You need at least one farmer villager inside of this thing. So this villager right here, the weaponsmith, has never been traded with before. As soon as I let the weaponsmith out of the boat, it should actually realize that it's way too far from its workstation and lose its job. We're going to go ahead and move our villagers over one by one. The plan here, move the villager over to the area. There you go, you lost his job. We'll move the villager over to the area, leave it in its boat, get in another boat, come back, grab another villager. I will be quick and make sure that these villagers don't toast up at nighttime like they did before, because that was tragic. It's villager time. Two villagers, count 'em, 1, 2, have made their way over to the brand new, beautiful home that I've built for them. This home, much better than their old home. So, this villager, all we need to do is move you over to the land, and then eventually you should realize that there's a composter up there and try and work at it. I think that's what you're doing exactly right now, yeah? Yeah, are you gonna take that? Yep, okay, cool, perfect. So you stay there. Now you need to quit your old job. You don't work at it anymore, dude. Move on. Let's go over to the land. Let's think about it for a little bit. You know what? Actually, let's do this. Let's go right in here. We have an extra workstation. We'll place it right there. Now do you realize? No, you don't realize. Okay. Well, we'll move it. Maybe you'll realize it. Hey, how about right there? Okay. Well, it doesn't matter because you are basically trapped in here. Boom. There we go. So we're going to need to find a way out of this thing for sure, but we have two villagers inside of the villager breeder now, which means this is pretty much ready to go. This is exciting. Okay, let's get out of this thing really, really quick here. What we'll actually do is we'll leave maybe a fence gate in there so we can get in and out. On the outside, though, we'll fill it in every time just to make it really low-key top secret. So extra carrots, you come with me. If we give each villager 12 carrots, they should do the thing. Farmer villager, you have the carrots. There you go. To give villagers food, all you need to do is throw it at them. Hey, you, buddy, over there, take the food. What do you think about this place? You need to quit your old job, though. You need to move on, dude. Come on, notice your friend over here. Let's go. Villagers, you can do it. This is kind of weird, encouraging villagers. But come on, come on, you can do it. I've never traded with that Fletcher villager before. I don't know why it wants to go to the old job still. I really don't know. Give him enough time, though, and he should forget about it. Now, I did hear the composter get used, so I'm wondering if the villager is putting its stuff in the composter. Farmer villager, you better not be throwing your food away. This is precious stuff. In fact, I'll donate even more food to your cause because I really care about this. So, you're the carrots. Yep. Okay. Let's go. It could take some time sometimes. Well, here's what I'm thinking. We'll let these guys sort it out. Maybe they'll figure it out. And then, while we're waiting for those villagers to figure out what's going on here, let's actually move down here and work on the dock really, really quick. So, I think that we should probably use a dispenser to dispense boats. I think that would be really cool. I also think that the water should maybe pour over this way and sort of be raised up a little bit. So maybe we start with like a cobblestone retaining wall, like kind of going up like this. We'll make the water 2 blocks wide. This water, again, will be like a waterfall dropping down into this water right here. It can be a waterfall because, well, we don't need to go back up this thing. Once we get the villagers out of this thing, they're out of this thing for good. Now, of course, I want to give a good base to this thing, so we'll go with cobblestone all the way over to wherever the end of this thing needs to be. So maybe like, probably like right there. Now, over here, what we're going to want to probably do is ice and, or you know what? What we're going to probably actually want to do is move this back a little bit, and we could actually get rid of the sign. We could actually probably just go with a vents gate. A vents gate would work just as well. All we need, basically, is the baby villagers that are born inside of this thing to be held back. Of course, I want to choose when they're leaving this thing, and hey, those are the first melons. Special moment, big moment. It happened! It happened! I hear a baby villager! I heard a baby villager and we missed it! How could I? How dare I? The Fletcher villager lost his whole job! There's a baby in there. It happened. Elites, it happened. And now let's talk about their clothes really, really quick. So the clothes of the baby villager is determined by two things, the clothes of the parents and the birth location. So the birth location is currently the jungle. This is the jungle biome over here, but the parent villagers both have taiga biome outfits. So some baby villagers will have the taiga outfit. Others will have the jungle one, and look at it, the baby fell into the trap and is going to be waiting over there, which is literally perfect. But what I probably want to do here is stop the thing for now. Now, actually, realistically, I don't have to right now because the villagers have no food. Every time they breed, their inventory is cleared out. Even if both villagers have like a bunch of food in their inventory, it gets emptied all the way. So basically, we need to wait for these crops to grow, for the farmer villager to harvest those crops, and then share the crops with that villager right there. Once each villager has enough crops, they will breed again if this thing is on, if they can see the beds. But anyways, if I want all jungle villagers, which I might, all I'll need to do is wait for jungle baby villagers and then circle those ones into here, move the tiger villagers out of it, and then boom, we are golden. But anyways, let's go back to this area over here, get this thing set up all the way. So we have a baby villager waiting right where it should be. Basically, here's what I'm thinking. We have a dispenser with a boat and then a button right there. If I hit this, boat drops, gate opens, enough time. Then the baby villager gets in the boat, then we just need to move over quickly and then sail out, and then boom, we can take this baby villager wherever we'd like to take it. Now, little problem, didn't really fully think about it, so we're gonna have a baby villager just sitting in the boat for now. It is what it is, but yeah, that's exactly how I want this thing to work. All we'll need to do is stock this thing up with boats, and then we'll basically be good to go. So now, finally, all that I need to do is create a covering for this area right here. I'm thinking probably spruce coming up, some sort of, covering in here that would look pretty good. Maybe I keep it pretty low so we can still see the light. And then, after the covering, all I need to do is plant a bunch of plants in here like crazy. I need to go crazy. So when it comes to plants outside of this thing, here's what I'm thinking. Of course, I will bone meal the ground if the ground is open. But for the most part, I'm thinking lots and lots of spruce leaves and oak leaves randomly mixed in here, sort of like we did out front of our starter house over there. I will, of course, leave this spot open though, because this is our secret way in if we ever need inside of this thing. I'll have the leaves pouring down off of the cliffs over here. I think they're actually probably terraformed pretty much perfectly. And yeah, that'll look really, really good. And then, when it comes to this thing over here, I'll have to cut down more trees, but we'll build up right on the side of this thing so it'll stay pretty close to it, probably with these logs right here. And then what we could do to switch it up a little bit is actually strip them. All of these logs get stripped, so this will stand out. Then I'll come back in with maybe cobblestone, maybe stone bricks, and do a simple small roof. This will actually go one higher. And yeah, slab roof probably going all the way up across this thing, very subtle, so this light stays nice and high above it. Still haven't fully decided on the lever, but now I am kind of thinking about putting it down here instead. Gamers, I've failed you. Last episode, I completely forgot. I was distracted with the project far away from home. Comment of the day. Last episode, we'll go ahead and do it now. Waddles, I think you should prioritize getting an elytra and raiding. You defeated the dragon a while ago. Haven't been to the incense, lol. Yay. Good point. So, the reason I haven't done it for so long is because I kind of like to space big milestones out. How I see it, in terms of exploration, getting an elytra is kind of the last big milestone. Kind of, again, in terms of exploration. So, yeah, have been waiting, will be doing it, wait for it, probably next episode, if we get lucky. Definitely going back to the end, though, next episode, so get hyped for that. Comment of the day for today's episode, episode number 37. He wasn't kidding when he said this is going to be the most uploaded Minecraft guide series. Yeah, you know, I've been absolutely 100%. I say it all the time on Twitter. I've been inspired and loving this world, so I keep playing it. And yeah, if I'm inspired, if I'm liking a world, obviously, yeah, I'm going to play it more. And yep, I meant it when I said it this time for sure. Most uploaded guide world. Hold on, it's nighttime. I can't go over there. But yeah, basically, I've been loving this world. I don't see any end in sight at all. We're getting close to episode 50, going to be a tour. That'll be a pretty cool tour because I feel like we have a lot of good things finished to show off. But yeah, very, very excited about this world and loving it. Alright gamers, I have finished the build. You can't really see it from over here, but you know where you can actually kind of see it from, thankfully, is this house right here. Everything is packed together in this world, and I love how it's coming together. It's like really organic, but we can see the light from here, which is perfect. I needed a good spot to be able to see that light from so I know if it's running or if it's not. Now, I don't really have an easy way over to it, so we'll just jump up here for now and check it out first. So, the terraforming, looking at it now, definitely a little flat on top, gonna have to fix that one. But the breeder and the area around it is pretty much mostly finished. Now, I know it's not much, it's really just a bunch of leaves thrown on the ground, but that's kind of the vibe that I'm going for here. It's a jungle. We want to bring the jungle definitely like back to life. I feel like I've chopped out, you know, a lot of the jungle in here, so yeah, I'm trying to restore it where I can. We're going to actually go ahead and add in a little bit of bamboo over here too, because bamboo is really, really cool looking, and I should definitely use it in my terraforming. So there we go. Maybe something kind of like this over here. I put a bunch of lanterns down, so we should be mostly spawn proof over here, and I did leave the secret entrance open. It's right here. If we ever need to get into it, that's how we get in. But these villagers have not been doing anything for a while. I'd like to go ahead and actually flick the lever, which I moved. By the way, this is closed off now. If we go down here and hit the lever, which I actually hit right back there, boom, this is on now and running. And we should actually probably get another baby villager very, very soon here, because I feel like maybe they have enough food. I'm not too sure if they do. Well, we'll have to wait and see. They're definitely staring at each other in some kind of way. You feeling anything, villagers? You feeling anything? I feel the magic. Come on. Come on, let's get a baby villager. Okay, well, maybe not right now. We'll give them some time. I'm gonna go ahead and leave this thing running again for the iron farm that I want to build very, very soon. We're gonna need three villagers. We have one sitting in the water over here. By the way, did get this thing loaded up over here with boats, so it's pretty much good to go. But yeah, I need a couple more baby villagers, so that's where we're gonna leave it for today's episode, elites. Thank you all so much for watching. If you haven't yet, smash that like button, subscribe for more Minecraft guide episodes, snapshots, everything cool like that. Today, big shout out to my patrons, Lord Zenera and Brown Banana. Until next time, stay fresh. I'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye, everyone.